What is going on, guys? My name is Brian and welcome back to the Game Shower, where we like to shower you with Square Enix news, leaks and rumors. And in today's video, we're gonna be talking about the best way to play Kingdom Hearts. And when I say Kingdom Hearts, I'm not just talking about the new Kingdom Hearts 3 or the Kingdom Hearts Remind DLC. I'm talking about you want to play Kingdom Hearts from the very start. If you're new here, follow me on social media and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Click on the bell to stay updated on all the latest Square Enix news, leaks and rumors, and let's get on with the video. So guys, I woke up to an exciting email and a tweet from the Kingdom Hearts Twitter page that stated that they were making the all-in-one package of Kingdom Hearts physical. Now, let me tell you something. The deal is crazy. So you know, when Kingdom Hearts 3 first came out, it came out a little over a year ago now, but when it came out, it was, you know, a $60 game, right? Well, how about you're about to get, let me tell you all the games that you're about to get. You'll get Kingdom Hearts 3, Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories, Kingdom Hearts 358 by 2 Days, Kingdom Hearts Recoded, Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Final Mix, Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance HD, Kingdom Hearts Back Cover, Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, A Fragmented Passage, and man, do I really need to say more? Do I really need to say more? Like, you heard all those games I just mentioned. That's approximately 10 or more Kingdom Hearts games. And that's honestly all the Kingdom Hearts games there is to play, except for the mobile game, you know, the mobile game where it's Union Cross. But honestly, you kind of need to play it to get Kingdom Hearts 3, but you could just kind of look up a summary video. I have a summary video. I'm going to link it up below. Excuse the quality of that video, but it is at least a summary so that you can understand why you're playing Kingdom Hearts 3 and any of the other Kingdom Hearts for that matter. But I just wanted to point out that when I got the email, I clicked on the link to see how much this physical version is going to cost, which honestly, by the way, guys, look at this cover art. If you notice, the little picture frames is the theme that they went with in the beginning of Kingdom Hearts 3 with the Dive to Heart scene. But you know how much they're asking for all of this? They're only asking for $49.99. Yes, the freaking all-in-one edition that when it first came out, it was about, I think, $100 in the PSN store. That version is coming physically to PS4 on March 17, 2020, physically with that amazing box art, all those games included for just $50. Guys, honestly, if you haven't played Kingdom Hearts and you just want to see what all the hype's about, this is honestly the best bang for your buck, the best deal, because if you buy all of them separately, trust me, it's going to cost you a little over, possibly up to $100, honestly, if you buy each one separately, because like, even with the deals and everything, they're approximately about, if you get like, for example, 1.5 and 2.5, you could probably get it for like $15. If you get Kingdom Hearts 3, you could probably get that for another $15. That's already $30. If you get the 2.8 with all the other games, it's about another $15. You'll be saving a little bit of money, honestly. Whether you get them used or not, this is honestly the best route to go. It's only $50 and you get the whole package. You get to play every Kingdom Hearts game and it's going to be such an amazing experience. You get the physical copy. The art cover is beautiful. It has Sora. It has everything you would want in the box cover. And it honestly portrays Sora being such the badass that he is. And it's just a great way to jump in if you haven't had the chance to play it. And even honestly, let's say if you're like me and you do have it, I want to get it myself just for that box cover. Like, that box cover looks amazing. But I don't know, guys, that's my opinion. Let me know down below what you guys think. Should people buy this? Is $50 a reasonable price? I honestly think it is. Like, you're getting your bang for your buck. Like, I still think Kingdom Hearts 3, as much as it's a, oh, I hate this game, or oh, Kingdom Hearts is all over the place kind of story, I still feel like that game is worth $50 on its own. And you're getting all of these other games added with it. So honestly, guys, if you haven't experienced Kingdom Hearts and if you're a big Kingdom Hearts fan, you owe it to yourself to buy this all-in-one package, especially because of that box art cover. Like, I know I've mentioned it like maybe 3 or 4 times during this video, but look at that box art cover. Like, I love it. Anyway, guys, as I mentioned, if you could just comment below whether you think people should get it, whether you're gonna get it yourself, let me know in the comment section down below. And as always, guys, thank you guys for giving the channel yet another view and for helping me get that much closer to my next milestone. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to hit that like button, because it really does help the channel and it helps the channel grow as well. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel to stay updated so that together we can shower everyone with Square Enix news, leaks, and rumors. This has been the Game Shower, where we just showered you with some Kingdom Hearts all-inclusive, all-in-one package news, man. keep being awesome, guys. Click on the link below to pre-order.